Okay, so the topic given to you is development is always against the environment. And now I ask Kostub to initiate the discussion. Kostub, please go ahead. Others, please mute yourself, all of you. Kostub.
Hello, everyone. Hello, am I audible?
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yes, go ahead.
Hello, everyone. Myself Kaustubh. So the topic given to us for today's group discussion is the development is always against the environment. So it is very interesting topic because few people will agree with this and few people will disagree with this. So I am expecting we will have a very fruitful discussion on this. So I will I open this discussion to everyone and put their opinion.
Okay, Ashish.
Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. I am Ashish Kumar, and I am going to open the discussion about development is always about environment. As far as my opinion is concerned, development is not always against environment. Majority of the development are against of the environment. So I am expecting from all of you to give healthy discussion on the topic. Thank you.
Okay, now Bhupendra.
Hello everyone, the topic given to us is the development is always against the environment. So development in today's era, development and environment are important topic to discuss, and the developments are going on. So environment is already going to affect it. So the world is facing the problem. So we have to discuss this topic, and this will be the great importance for the discussion of this topic. So we should see in discussion.
Okay, Samir.
Good afternoon, everyone. So the topic for today's discussion is development is always against the environment. And I think this topic includes two main things that we need to see. First one is what we are assuming as development. So what I interpret by development is progress in infrastructure, progress in the social level of the people, the quality of life of people is improving. That's what I interpret of as development. The second one being the environment. So environment consists of various factors is what I consider, because there are various kinds of things that are associated with environment. For example, there is the level of sound, noise, also the quality of air, the quality of land, the soil nutrient, the food that we are eating, the balance about it. So there are many number of things that we consider environment, and I think it will be a very diverse topic to discuss. And what I feel is that there are many characteristics of both development and environment that many times collide, and many times they go hand in hand. So we can have many aspects of it based on individual personalities. And I think the discussion will be very fruitful because of the fact that the more diverse people discuss this topic, the more points will come into the picture. So I think all of us can contribute very fruitfully to this discussion. And I would like to invite everyone to contribute with their points. And hopefully we can make a successful endeavor through this group discussion. So I invite all of you. Thank you.
Okay, Bhupendra. Poorv.
So, good evening, everyone. The topic for our discussion today is development is always against environment. The two keywords that I see in the topic are development and environment. So, proceeding with my introduction, I would like to say that our environment is very, very delicate. And I think this is the reason why this topic comes into picture. As we know that there are various measures of environmental concerns going on all around the world. For example, global warming, deforestation, and we can see their effects. Like we are having less rains in regions and various other effects that are coming into play due to the delicate balance between the so-called development and environment. So I think yes, development should be it should be both social, economical, and I think the overall development should also focus towards creating a balance between what development we are scene that is happening and the environment that we are living in. So okay. I think we should start our discussion now.
Okay, Pranjal, I think you can proceed.
There is enough for everyone's need, but not a single penny for anyone's greed. Good evening, everyone. This is Pranjal Shukla, and I feel honored to be a part of this dais. Today's topic of discussion is development is always against environment. In today's scenario, I believe this is going to be a very fruitful topic of discussion, seeing the sense of the industry moving towards Industry 4, be it towards the sense of global warming, deforestation, or the sense of the countries where they are moving towards a poor carbon footprint. I believe that this dais would be able to get fruitful discussion. We will critically analyze this topic, and I welcome you all to the floor. Thank you.
Okay, Abhinav.
Good evening, dear friends. As I am glad to start in the topic, in my opinion, that the development and environment both are two sides of the coin. If one is affected, then definitely second is affected. So we need a real concern about either the development, either the environment. In my opinion, both are beneficial to our human being as the other creature of the earth. So I think this is a very interesting topic. And I requested all of you that we will definitely get a fruitful points on this.
Okay, Shivam. Unmute. You have to unmute.
Hello, everyone. This is Shivam Agrawal, and I'm very glad that sir has given me the chance to initiate the topic. So our given topic today is development is always against environment. So as we all know that somebody will be in favor and somebody will be in against of that. I would like to say that as we are developing in our lifestyle, the environment is also being affected. So government policies are also changing or being strict for the environment as well. So I would say it as sustainable development basically. So I feel that it is a very important and quite current topic. So let us discuss about it. And I hope we all will conclude at a very optimal point. Thank you.
Okay. Now what I do, Surinder, you have talked, no? Surinder, unmute yourself. Unmute. Yeah.
Hello, friends. My name is Surendra. Today's our topic is development is always against the environment. I believe that everyone has, every topic has different opinions. In my opinion, not always the development is against environment. Some developments are like, if you see the innovations, like now everyone is going towards solar energy. Those are like eco-friendly. So I say like, now the world is knowing what importance of environment. So now the world is giving more importance to the eco-friendly projects. And because of this COVID, the importance given to the environment may be delayed. So I would like to invite everyone to give their opinions on this discussion.
Okay, now what I do, everybody is done. I have not missed anybody, right? So now what we do, I open the house for the discussion for a couple of minutes, and then I will ask each one of you again to conclude in less time. So I open the house for discussion now.
Okay, so I want to start by saying that there were many questions.
You would like to start our discussion?
That side of coin, that is one being the development and the other, thank you. So the other one being the environment and the other one being the development. What I want to highlight is a point that sustainable development, which is also one of a key kind of a development. And that's where I think many of the participants wanted to point out that there are certain
sustainable development is focusing upon. In the past, if we see that all the industries were at a rush for their profits, they were at a rush for maximizing their maximizing their sales. But right now, sustainable development is something which the industry is focusing at right now. Definitely, Samir, I agree with your point that sustainable development is something which the industry is right now focusing towards.
Every industry is focusing on sustainable development.
What is the sustainable development?
We need to think more and more ways of sustainable development rather than
Hello, Samir. First, we discuss what is the sustainable development. In sustainable development, we have to save resources for the future generations so that we can meet our demands and future demands can be also be applicable. So we are also moving towards the eco-friendly development, like solar energy and electrical vehicles, so that we cannot harm environment.
I would like to say that as we are doing our development, the government is also saying that we have to take into account the environment as well. If suppose there is a thermal power plant, in that case, if it is blowing a lot of rush in the environment, there is a government separate policy nowadays so that everyone, every plant or every manager there can decide whether
the industries are focusing towards the
respected friend, I am partially agreed with you. Friend, I am partially agreed with you. I want to add some point on this topic that development and environment both are not different things. They are only the just two sides of the coin. If one is affected, then definitely other will be affected. But since we human beings and other creatures are living in the environment, then it is our duty. It is our duty to such develop such a infrastructure that can we can we can develop a
for the betterment of the life of the community
So in my opinion, the environment in which we are living, there will be no any kind of in my opinion, the environment we are living, there will be nothing, anything will be possible without any development. So we have only just
because our application to come to a consensus, nothing can be 100% efficient.
Kindly respected friend, kindly listen to me. Kindly listen to me. In the development is nothing. Development is never against the environment. Development is never against the environment.
There are certain kinds of development
which are against the environment. If it is in sustainable manner, it will be never.
Due to this, you have to accept
the broader aspect of development. We need to see
there are broader.
We'll also save the environment because the
tell you about the smart city project of the government of India, where they are going to take a lot of deforestation in the state of Andhra, in the state of Telangana.
In my opinion, both are simultaneous. Both are simultaneous effect. In my opinion, both are in simultaneous effect. Whenever our creature has been created on the earth, there will be against fighting about the development and the environment. But it is,
we have to see on the balance.
I think we can also agree to the point that we will have to applaud
friend, kindly
EV policy which is there.
Friend,
we give out a lot of incentives to the people out there.
It's not always about the policy. It's not always about the government policy. There are certain kind of development activities.
If the development is not destructive, we should focus
discuss.
And I am partially agreed with you. Friend, I am partially agreed with you.
Important because
there are ethics also. Now I think we should conclude.
Let me give the particular industry or their employees.
Now, okay, Shivam. Now we have to conclude. So I start from Surendra. Surendra, can you conclude now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, if you see the development, I mean, one second. Our friends has given many opinions. Our government, if you see their opinions, like government is also focusing on the environment, but because of these COVID situation, everything got disturbed, and now the plans are delayed. So government should focus more on environment in coming days and should put some strict restrictions on factories and everything, so that our air is pure and everything will be green.
Okay, now Shivam.
Yes, sir. After listening to everyone's point, I would like to conclude that I think everyone is agree with that development and environment goes in hand in hand, but this concern has raised because of the environment is being affected. So I would like to say that as the technology in the future will enhance, it will enable us to protect our environment in well manner. So there will not be this type of thing, and sustainable development will go on. Thank you.
Okay, Abhinav.
Thank you, sir. My friends have good discussions on the environment and development, and they have given lot of the points, which are some points are proving that development is great, and some points are showing that environment is great. But my point is, sir, development and environment both are coexistence with society, and we need to sacrifice one at a thing. Meanwhile, when we are developing more and more, somewhere the environment is continuously harassing, and the future requirement is that we have to do the sustainable development, which will be better option for us.
Okay, then Apoorv, I think we can go with you.
I think, guys, we had the discussion we had was not very smooth, probably we didn't reach a consensus because we were not able to clearly understand each of us. The thing is, I noted down some very valid points that were made during the discussion. There were points made that environment and development are both sides of a coin, of the same coin, and I totally agree to it. Then there were points made that today's development that we are having is very questionable. But the thing is, I want to say that governments in India and all around the world are doing a lot to see into this. And we have measures like Kyoto Protocol, which is a global example of how people are concerned toward environment, including taking development further. Also, Sameer talked about sustainable development, which is the very, actually he took my point, which I was going to say, and I think it is a very, very valid point. I think, that's all why I want to conclude, and thank you for the discussion.
Okay, Ashish.
Yes, sir. After the healthy discussion, I would like to conclude that all the development is there. Development.
I request all of you to mute yourself, except the person who is speaking. It will be clear.
Yes, sir. I would like to conclude that development is also needed, and environment is also should not be degraded. Sustainable development is a way from where environment should not be degraded. And also some friends have concluded that government is not working, and government is working. There are some points where government need to enhance their policy, but government is also working. Thank you.
Kostup?
Hello. So we had a discussion on whether development is always against the environment. So I partially agree with this. because up till now it has been that case, unfortunately. But the word we cannot say that it will always be against the environment, because as an engineer, it will be very pessimistic of us if we accept that. We should take it as a challenge to make develop a technology, what we call as sustainable development, in a such a way that they can coexist together. And for this, very important is that the developed nation took more responsibility, because developing nation like India, they are on their growth. So for them to depend mostly on the solar, etc., it will be little difficult. But for the developed nation, it will be easier. So they should take the initiative, and others should, other nations should follow them. That is my opinion. So as it was very interesting topic, and everyone had a different opinion, so it was quite a chaotic discussion we had. But at the end, we, I think everyone put very interesting points.
Bhupender?
So we had very fruitful discussion, and each one is agreeing on the point that development and the environment both are the different sides of a coin. So development should go, we cannot avoid development, and development should be balanced and sustainable, so that we can do betterment in the life of the people, and environment can also be protected. So there are different schemes of the government of India or global world, like Kyoto Protocol, as mentioned by Apoorv, India's National Cooling Action Plan, solar power and green buildings. There are many schemes, so that we can save our environment, and in parallel, so development cannot be avoided, because it is very important.
Amir?
So we had a very fruitful discussion, and almost a variety of points and areas were covered by various participants, like electric vehicles, deforestation policies by nations, different nations, also the role of international organizations on it. And I think almost everyone on this group was agreeing that development is necessary, and what kind of development that we need to do is sustainable development. I think everyone was trying to make a point that sustainable development is the future, in which we can preserve both development as well as environment. Also, there were many participants that cited the importance of environment and also its synergy with the development also. And I think I completely agree with them, because of the fact that without environment, there is there will be no development, there will be no scope of development, because first of all, we need a suitable environment for our living. And after that, we can enhance that environment by various developmental processes. And I think there were many examples that were cited by the participants, like good for environment causes, or there was one point that Pranjal also made, which I don't completely agree, which is that development is not always profit based, or it's not profit, it's always profit centric. And I think that sustainable development can be in synergy with the profit. And we have seen many examples of industries implementing those kinds of developmental strategies, which is both profitable, highly profitable, and also at the same time, good for environment. So I don't completely agree on that point that development will always have some negative kind of impact on environment. It's just that the planning or the new technologies that are emerging will definitely help sustainable development to step in the mainstream developmental processes. And I think we had a very good discussion, and covering almost all of the universe of the development and environment. And yeah, thank you.
Ranjan?
Had a very good discussion on the topic at hand. We did start our discussion with the development and the environment part of it, and we agreed that there needs to exist a symbiotic relationship between the two. We agreed that they are the two sides of a single coin. Then we moved towards a discussion towards the policies which are being created, be it the EV policy or the smart cities. There were some people who said that we also need to take care of the ethics, but that is always understandable. There were topics about how the industry is profit driven. There were rebuttals about that development might not always be profit centric. That is the way how the corporate social responsibility works in the society right now. we agreed that there is an intent by the current government, there is a need, but what needs to be checked is how it will be implemented on the plan of action. Thank you.
Anybody left for conclusion? I think it's all done. Okay. So, let me tell you first, when introduction chance is given to you, majority of you are trying to only speak two lines and nothing about the subject topic and opening the house. First chance was given to Kaustubh for introduction, and Kaustubh just said, okay, friends, this is the topic and I'm very sure we all can contribute into this. So let's start the discussion. Kaustubh, you have to add one or two more lines. I told you these sentences to be used. These sentences are to be used when you have nothing to say, but you were having something to say in this, right? So whenever some topic is given to you in which you can contribute, do not end up abruptly. And in the actual situation, when only one fellow is to introduce, and if you're getting more time, that is your opportunity. So do not try to restrict your time. If you want to take more time, you keep on speaking. There is no trouble in that. You should have something to speak, 3-4 lines to speak. The other general topic, general lines are there. Like, if friends, good evening, my name is Kaustubh and I take the opportunity to initiate the discussion. Friends, the topic given for the discussion today is, you can read the topic. And in my opinion, I agree to this topic. I do not agree to this topic. I partially agree to this topic. I largely disagree to the topic. I largely agree to the topic. So you take a stand, actually. Whatever stand you want to take, you at least take a stand. If I give you this statement, where do you take your stand? Okay, friends, the topic given for the discussion is development always against environment. So friends, I largely disagree with this statement. You know, whenever exception words are given, radical words are given, always, absolutely, never. These are not correct statements. These are the extreme words. Statements are not correct. Development versus environment. That is a different meaning. Development against the environment. Different meaning. Development always against the environment. Development always against the environment. Wrong statement. Always. Can you mute yourself, all of you? I think some sound problem is coming. Mute yourself, Abhinav. Abhinav, mute. Mute yourself, Abhinav.
Sir. Sir, I don't know how to mute.
Okay. So anyhow, then not a problem. So jahan pe ye word aa jayenge na, radical word aa jayega, un words se statement change ho jata hai. To aapne pehle ek introduction mein stand le sakte ho, to lo. If you can take a stand in the introduction, you take the stand. Do you agree with this statement? No, sir, largely I don't agree. I agree only partially. I agree but to small extent. So say that particular line. Okay, friends, good evening. My name is Vijender Singh and I take the opportunity to initiate the discussion. Friends, the topic for the discussion given is development always against environment. I largely disagree with this statement. So to give my perspective, no doubt development is against environment, but not always. There's a term called sustainable development also, which makes the development pro environment. It is not so. Development can be made in such a way that environment degradation is not there. So aapko ek stand lena apna, aur wo 4-5 line honi chahiye. Perspective aapko dena hai. Jaise I think Sameer ne ek perspective diya ki what is the meaning of environment, what is the meaning of development, so what is the aspects, what we are talking about. Aapne divide karna hai. So introduction mein aapko kahan benefit milega? Number one, ye do teen line aapne bolni hai. Number two, यार स्टैंड ले लो ना कोई. इधर यू विल एग्री और यू विल डिसएग्री और यू विल पार्शियली एग्री और पार्शियली डिसएग्री. लाइक द टॉपिक, वुमेन आर गुड मैनेजर्स और नॉट, वुमेन कैन बी गुड ड्राइवर और नॉट. तो फ्रेंड्स, आई विल माय पर्सपेक्टिव इज दैट वुमेन आर ऑलरेडी गुड मैनेजर्स. आई डोंट नो व्हाई वी आर इवन डिस्कसिंग इट, बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट अ जेंडर स्पेसिफिक, बट यस, आई थिंक वी आर डिस्कसिंग इट बिकॉज वी आर टॉकिंग फ्रॉम द इंडियन पर्सपेक्टिव. इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द अमेरिकन पर्सपेक्टिव, मे बी दिस स्टेटमेंट इज नॉट वैलिड. So, आपने स्टैंड लेना है. यू हैव टू टेक अ स्टैंड. नाउ कौस्तुभ, यू डिड नॉट स्पीक मच लाइंस अबाउट दैट. आशीष, आपने पॉइंट अच्छा स्टार्ट किया. नॉट ऑलवेज के बारे में आपने फोकस किया कि ऑलवेज, यू सेड दैट इट इज नॉट ऑलवेज ट्रू. मेजोरिटी ऑफ द टाइम यस इट इज देयर, बट नॉट ऑलवेज ट्रू. आशीष, वो वर्ड आपका सही था, लेकिन आप भी इसको लंबा नहीं खींच पाए, इंट्रोडक्शन को ज्यादा नहीं ले पाए. तो आपने बहुत जल्दी इसको जो अपॉर्चुनिटी था दैट यू हैंडेड ओवर टू समबडी, राइट? दैट इज नॉट टू बी डन. आपकी भूपेंद्र बहुत अच्छी स्टार्टिंग नहीं हुई. I don't know, Bhupender, you can speak. I'm of the opinion you can speak. But normally you are hesitating. You're not speaking actually. If your communication is such that you are not in position to speak long sentences, at least speak small sentences in between. When you are discussing among yourselves, at that time you can use a very, very small, small word, two words, sentences to just put your point. When everybody, there's a chaos, when there's a chaos, like this is a big group, you know, I think how many, 4, 3, 7, 10 people are sitting here. Normally it is a 5, 6, right? So you kept on popping in today and 10 people are there now. So you know what happens is when there's a chaos, at that time, how to make yourself swim in the chaos? You are not to use a long sentence. Somebody is speaking and you are also simultaneously speaking. Don't do that. Be silent. And when somebody speaks, like Abhinav was speaking, Abhinav is speaking very smooth. When Abhinav is speaking, just cut him and substitute your two words. Right, Abhinav. But you understand there's a term called sustainable development. Sustainable development. Abhinav, do you know there's a sustainable development also? Sustainable development. So just focus on 2-3 words whenever chaos is there and speak loudly. One or two moments, like Pranjal entered with smart city stuff. When chaos was going on, everybody was talking. Then Pranjal took energy and jumped with a smart city word, 2-3 words. And he could enter into that particular chaotic discussion. So you need to garner the energy, come from the behind and with the full speed and enter into the discussion. Something like that, when the chaos is going on. But there is always a right time to enter in the chaos. Always a right time. When a very smooth fellow starts speaking and he's in between the sentence, everybody is listening to him, that time, you cut him short and entered into the discussion. Something like that you have to do. But it comes with the practice. If you waiting for sentence to be completed, all the 10 guys are waiting for him to complete the sentence. And everybody will simultaneously start speaking. But you are to enter when that is not the case. This is what you have to do. Baki, Bhupender, this Apurv, you know, you can speak good. I mean, you are speaking also good. But only thing is, that aggression with which you have to enter all the time, you are not showing that aggression. So if I give the opportunity everyone to speak for 5 minutes, Apurv, there will not be anything wrong with you. You will speak it out. You will speak it out. But then you have to show the aggression and you have to enter again and again, and you have to come out with your points. That hesitation you have to remove somehow. You have to do that. Then I think I go to Pranjal. Starting was good. But Pranjal, when you are speaking, do not refer your copies in the introduction. Because when you give introduction, you have to see others. This is online only. So in the offline also, you will not get time to see your copy and then maintain eye contacts. Because you have to maintain eye contacts. Even now, when you are talking to somebody, there's an audience sitting there and you have to maintain eye contacts with each and everybody. So try to avoid seeing copies. If you want to see the copy, you can basically see with your eyes, not with your head. You know, there's a two ways to see. I can see everything written in my copy as of now with my eyes. I will sit in such a posture that where I can refer everything that I've written. When I'm writing, it's okay. But when I'm talking to others, I can use my eyes to basically see what I've written, not my head. This is not a right person, right way to see. That is what you have to avoid. That is, the rest is good. I mean, introduction was part was good, Pranjal. Your conclusion also good. Try to keep yourself calm and show some kind of smiling face also in between, calmness. And that is the one thing which you can add in your present in this particular discussion. That is where we can improve. Abhinav, you said two sides of the coin. That concept was good. You know, in every discussion, sometime you impress somebody with the phrase two sides of the coin. Who gave this term? First of all, Abhinav gave it, right? And everybody was using it then. So this was a contribution to the discussion by Abhinav. Two sides of the same coin, and everybody talked about this then. Think of something like this. Think of something like this. And then when you said it first time, even I was impressed. Yes, he thought of something actually. He thought of something like two sides of the coin. They go hand in hand. So wo aisa kuch agar tum impress kar sakte ho kuch cheez se, bol ke kuch aisi cheez bata ke, wo cheez bahut help karti hai, jisko baki log bhi अगर ये चीज हमें इंट्रोडक्शन में किया होता तो वी वुड हैव गिवन अ एंटायर ट्रैक टू द डिस्कशन एंड इनएडवर्टेंटली एवरीबॉडी विल स्टार्ट स्पीकिंग दैट बिकॉज़ दे लाइक्ड इट यू नो सो अभिनव स्टार्टिंग में ही आपने इंट्रोडक्शन में बोला देयर आर टू साइड्स ऑफ द कॉइन दैट इज अ इनोवेटिव स्टफ दैट हेल्प्स यू बाकी आई कॉन्टेक्ट मेंटेन करना है अभिनव जो आप नहीं मेंटेन कर पा रहे हो और दूसरा बिकॉज ऑफ द पोस्चर सिटिंग पोस्चर आई एम नॉट इन पोजिशन टू सी यू लेकिन आपके कम्युनिकेशन में आपका जो स्पीकिंग का है वो ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड है मतलब आप बहुत फ्लुएंटली नहीं बोल पाते हो देयर इज अ ट्रबल आई थिंक यू हैव तो उसकी प्रैक्टिस करनी पड़ेगी दिस ऑल कम्स विद द प्रैक्टिस एंड पेस मेंटेन करना पड़ेगा आपको दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम देन आई थिंक दिस सुरेंद्र यू कुड नॉट स्पीक मच आई वांट टू नो व्हाट वाज द इशू यस सुरेंद्र
आई एम न्यू टू दिस जीडी टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक्स
सो हाउ यू फाउंड इट The chaotic situation, huh? First time you came yes, and sir. There are 10 guys sitting, huh?
Yes, sir.
No, normally it is not there. There are 4 or 5, you are going for NTPC or something?
NTPC, sir.
So there are 5 or 6 students only are sitting there, not 10. That is number one.
Yes, sir. And 7 members are there in my group.
You have already had. They have yes, already sir, sent you, right?
Yes, sir. They have sent you short. They have sent us short list.
So 7 guys are there, huh?
Yes, sir. 7.
Okay. So that is what actually there is going to be a little better. When is your GD?
17, sir.
17. So don't worry. That chaotic situation will not be there. But you know, you need to understand they are giving you opportunity to speak. And okay. Where you can get the mileage is introduction, you know. Introduction you can really do good. And then you can enter also later on. So introduction may learn those 3-4 lines when I give you chance. The introduction you have done good, believe me, you will sail through. If introduction you have done good, you will sail through in this NTPC at least I'm telling. In this okay. online stuff, you need not to fight much for doing really good introduction. Okay. So, what was the hesitation, Surinder? What else?
No, sir.
Could you listen to what others were saying clearly?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm able to listen.
So, conclusion, you have to give conclusion which others are also talking about. It's a collective yes, opinion has to be there, you know, that yes, part is there. Okay. Right? And Bhupender, I have given you the feedback. Samir, it's good. आपने अच्छा जैसे आपका बोलते हैं वैसा आपने ठीक किया. बस समीर थोड़ा सा आपको you speak little more, 30% more बोलते हो तुम. You speak 30% more. So sometime you need not to invest that much of energy. You know that is not bad, but sometime you know person is sitting with some kind of attitude. The person observer is sitting. You know, why is speaking so much? Suppose I do not have that capability even to speak, and you are speaking better than me. Then interpersonal clash comes, you know, that is how it sometimes comes. So 30% reduce karo, then everything else will be good. Anybody has, I have Shivam. Shivam, tumhara maine feedback diya. To sustainable development word tumne coin kiya, right? Isme discussion mein. And I think that was good. So that was, tumne coin kiya tha, Samir? Sustainable development. But you did not introduction mein to tumne nahi bola tha, baad mein bola tha.
Maine introduction mein nahi bola kyunki wo... उस टाइम तक मेरे को आया भी नहीं था आइडिया और
ये इंट्रोडक्शन में होना चाहिए था ये इंट्रोडक्शन में होना चाहिए था द बेस्ट इंट्रोडक्शन नाउ व्हिच आफ्टर लिसनिंग टू यू वुड हैव बीन कि फ्रेंड्स आई डू नॉट एग्री विद द स्टेटमेंट लार्जली इट मे बी इट्स लार्जली इट्स नॉट ट्रू दिस स्टेटमेंट यस डेवलपमेंट सम टाइम इज अगेंस्ट द एनवायरमेंट सो डेवलपमेंट एंड एनवायरमेंट दे आर द टू साइड्स ऑफ द कॉइन एंड फ्रेंड्स देयर इज अ टर्म कॉल्ड सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट So introduction में अगर सारा मैं मिक्स कर दूं तो this would have been the best introduction to start with.
अभिनव और मेरा पॉइंट मिक्स हो
गया. मिक्स हो गया तुम्हारा. That is how it would have been.
अच्छा.
Okay. So before we go for next, anything you want to ask?
सर मेरा feedback दे दीजिए शिवम.
शिवम तुम्हारा feedback वही है कि एक तो energy level कम आपका और तुम्हें थोड़ा ज़्यादा बोलना है. Actually क्या होता है यार feedback एक level पे देना is better. आप में से बहुत से लोगों का पहला है like अभिनव शिवम तुम्हारा सुरेंद्र का पहला है तो मैं बहुत फीडबैक मैं दूंगा नहीं अभी क्योंकि अभी यू जस्ट स्टार्टेड यू जस्ट लर्न हाउ इट इज टू बी डन बाकी जैसे इसका प्रांजल का अच्छा था लेवल अच्छा था तो उसको मैं वो बोल दिया लेकिन बाकी जिनका नहीं है अभी उनको लर्न करना है जस्ट ग्रो विद पेस ऑफ टाइम एंड देन दिस विल कम रुद्र वेलकम यू जस्ट पॉप्ड इन राइट सो अभी तुमने कुछ सुना हमने जो बोला कुड यू लर्न लिटिल बिट अबाउट दैट कैन यू हियर मी I can't hear you. Rudra, I can't hear you. No, I can't hear you, Rudra. Okay, so can we go for next? Can we start next now? Okay.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Aapur.
Sir, this time while we were doing individual introduction, I tried to balance my points. You know, you always say that I give so much of information initially. So I, when you said the topic, I wrote some few points with me. But the thing is that I tried to mild it down, and that's why I did that. And that's why I feel introduction good. I was not satisfied with it.
No, no, so, speak again. I could not get your point.
अच्छा मैं दोबारा बोलता हूँ सर. Actually जो introduction, individual introduction दिया था ना सर.
Yes.
उसमें आपने बोला है कि बहुत ज़्यादा information मत दिया करो.
Details and data is not to be given.
हाँ. But मैंने जो points लिखे थे यहाँ पे, वो मैं फिर उनको मतलब बोला नहीं मैं मतलब technically बहुत ज़्यादा सोचने लग गया कि ये बहुत ज़्यादा हो जाएगा मतलब information होगी कि नहीं तो उस मुझे मतलब वो सैटिस्फैक्टरी नहीं लगा आपने फर्स्ट okay. जो
मतलब तुम्हें लगता तो है कि तुम्हें देनी चाहिए थी इंफॉर्मेशन राइट
हाँ
आपको लग रहा था कि वो इंफॉर्मेशन देनी चाहिए थी
हाँ मतलब क्योंकि सर मैं बहुत कम बोला ऐसा मुझे लगा
हाँ तो बताओ क्या लिखा था तुमने बोलने के लिए व्हाट यू हैड रिटन टेल मी लिखा क्या था
जैसे कि सर एक तो वही सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट का पॉइंट लिखा था
वो तो बोलना चाहिए था तुम्हें शुरू में क्या लिखा होता तुमने बोलो
तो क्या रियल में बोल के दिखाऊं
हाँ बोलो बोलो
ठीक है मैं इंट्रोडक्शन देता हूँ दोबारा तो हेलो गाइस topic has are development and environment. So we should first understand them. Development, as we say, you know, today's development that we see through our eyes is mostly about money making process. But I think that it should be a wholesome development that a person should experience. It should contain the social aspects and the economical aspects. Coming to the environment part, our environment since its inception is very, very delicate. And we need to understand that the balance between environment and development. Then there are various issues of global warming, which are recognized globally, of course, because they're affecting all types of life forms on Earth. There have been Assam floods and Bihar floods, which are, first causes of continuous deforestation happening all around.
But introduction में बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं हो जाएगा. Example भी cite करना चल जाता है.
Let him speak.
चल जाता. Okay.
Let him speak. हाँ.
बोलो. But I think हाँ तो. But I think that I should give chance to other participants and open the discussion.
ये तुमने सब लिखा था ना? अभी इसमें क्या है? इसमें अपूर्व आपका global warming, Assam and Bihar flood. That is the part which you should not spoken in introduction.
Okay. So, yeh doubt tha sir mera.
Global warming and Assam and Bihar flood is a detail. Rest is everything introduction. But the trouble with you is the pace at which you are speaking. Usme aapko ko bolne nahi dega, kaat dega pehle hi. Lekin jaisa 2 minute ka agar chance milta to tum bolte kya trouble tha usme? Wo to tum introduction hi de rahe the. You were just introducing the topic to others. But when you entered into global warming, in fact, Bhupender started mentioning Kyoto Protocol in the conclusion. So Kyoto Protocol, Bhupender was not even discussed, I think. Was it?
Before me, Apoor mentioned in.
Sir, वो मैंने बोला था और फिर उसका मेरा influence लेके उसने बोला था कि Apoor said like this, ऐसा करके.
नहीं, Kyoto Protocol और बहुत ज़्यादा detail में तुम conclusion में कुछ बोल रहे थे. I don't know. Was it? It was not conclusion statement.
Conclusion में डाला था सर मैंने. The government is already doing so much to, decrease the impact on environment. For example, Kyoto Protocol is a global example of the efforts.
But that is not the conclusion part. And I tell you honestly, like Kyoto Protocol is a deviation. You cannot justify Kyoto in this statement. Aap bata nahi paoge. Kyoto Protocol kya hai? It is a discussion among governments to reduce the, mitigate the impact of carbon dioxide emission. Global warming ko impact ko reduce karne ke liye, these are governments are thinking. To wo thoda deviation ho jayega. Topic ye hai ki bhai ye batao, कि क्या डेवलपमेंट एनवायरनमेंट के साथ उसमें क्लैश है. टॉपिक ये है, ठीक है, एनवायरनमेंट खराब हो गया, अब उसको कैसे ठीक करना है, उसका क्या करें, वो क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल की बात आएगी. हाउ टू मेंटेन सस्टेनेबिलिटी, दैट इज क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल, द रोल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट्स और सोसाइटीज.
Also, one can say that development in auto industry, which led to rise of electric vehicles, is actually in line with Kyoto protocols. And so here the development is in line with environment. So we can,
sir, can we mention, sir, can we mention different schemes?
Actually, justify karna mushkil ho jayega na. Tum main important points bata nahi rahe ho, tum uske bahut specific mein chale ja rahe ho. Jo main important points hai na, wo see, nobody talked about ke. It is not development is nothing but utilization of the resources. You know, for development, you need to utilize the resources. Now, same development in developing country and same development in developed country does not lead to the same environmental degradation. When you make a road in India, when you make a road in America, the environmental degradation is not same. So it is not the use of resources. It is efficient or inefficient use of the resources that leads to the environmental degradation. So friend, for development, you need to use the resource. But how efficiently you are using the resource, that will decide whether environmental degradation will be there or not. That is what you have to think of actually. Is tarike se, these are basic things you have to talk about. Then government policies and all, that is wo agla level chala jata hai. मेरे को बड़े सिंपल लेवल पे, एक स्ट्रेट लेवल पे होलिस्टिकली पॉइंट को डिस्कस करना होता है, दैट्स इट. बहुत इंट्रिकेसीज में नहीं. इंट्रिकेसीज में तो तुम तब जाओ अगर तुम बेसिक्स कर चुके हो. सी, इफ यू आस्क मी सर, टेक माय इंटरव्यू ऑफ अ सब्जेक्ट, अनलेस अंटिल आई आस्क यू बेसिक लॉज, भाई मेरे को फर्स्ट लॉ, सेकंड लॉ, थर्ड लॉ, थर्मोडायनेमिक्स का बताओ. अनलेस अंटिल आई आस्क यू दैट, आई शुड नॉट एंटर इनटू डीप इनटू द सब्जेक्ट. तुम्हें बेसिक नहीं आता तो डीप में जाके क्या फायदा होगा. तो तुम्हें इसके एबीसी, यू डोंट नो द एबीसी ऑफ दिस टॉपिक, सो व्हाई यू आर एंटरिंग इनटू क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल एंड दोहा एंड कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑफ पार्टीज, उसका कोई मतलब नहीं रहेगा क्योंकि यू कैन नॉट जस्टिफाई दैट, बिलीव मी, यू कैन नॉट डू दैट. बेसिक्स आपको बोलने हैं, और अगर तुम बोल भी रहे हो क्योटो प्रोटोकॉल, देन इन व्हाट कॉन्टेक्स्ट यू आर स्पीकिंग दैट, वो जस्टिफाई नहीं कर पाओगे. नाम लेने के लिए तुमने ले दिया, जस्टिफाई नहीं कर पाओगे तुम कि क्या कहां पे उसको फिट कर रहे थे. That will be difficult actually. So conclusion has to be कि क्या बोला वो overall. Introduction, perspective, data जितना भी है ना बीच में डालो, वो discussion के बीच में data डालो. तो Apoorv, your points, whatever you had written, they were to be put in introduction and you finished it early. लेकिन वो holistic, वो होने, generic होने चाहिए, details नहीं होनी चाहिए. Assam, Bihar flood. And I tell you one thing, Assam and Bihar flood is not only related to environmental degradation. वो बहुत पहले से आती हैं, जब से एनवायरनमेंट ठीक भी था तब से भी आती हैं, बिकॉज दैट इज ब्रह्मपुत्र इशू, दैट वो आता ही है, दैट इज सॉरो ऑफ बिहार, नाउ व्हाट टू डू फॉर दैट, वो शुरू से था. तो अगर कोई आपने ऐसा पॉइंट बोल दिया जिसका लॉजिक नहीं है तो वो आपके नेगेटिव चला जाएगा. सो दिस इज हाउ यू आर टू बेसिकली टॉक, राइट. सो कैन वी गो फॉर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक नाउ?
यस सर.
ओके, आई गिव यू नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. Deeply religious societies are less developed societies. Deeply religious societies are less developed societies. I give you 1 minute to think for this. Deeply religious societies are less developed societies.
Sir, can I join tomorrow, sir? Because I have some important task.
Shivam, what happened?
Sir, actually, I have some other things, sir.
You want to go, right? Yes. You can exit.
Thank you.
Okay, Bhupender, you can speak.
Hello friends, the topic given to us is the deeply religious societies are less developed societies. So we should first see why, what is the reason behind that. And I don't agree completely that deeply religious societies are less developed. So I partially agree with this. So let's see how discussion goes on and what fruitful discussion we have.
Okay, Surendra.
Hello friends, my name is Surendra. Our today's GD topic is deeply religious societies are less developed societies. I don't think deeply religious societies are not developed societies, because if you see the idea of religion, if you see the idea of religion, where it come from, like it came to unite the people. The first, very first point of religion is to unite the people. By uniting people, it encourages to develop. So after many years, the religion meaning has changed, and now it is making more development than now it is making. Now it is turning toward less development. So if we see the very meaning of the religion, it is for development of humans. So because of few people, the meaning, because few people has changed that meaning, they used it for their own uses. So they changed the very purpose of that religion. And now the religions are now, the meaning of religion is now towards less development. So I would like to invite all the people to give their opinions on this topic.
Okay, now I think Pranjal.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Pranjal Shukla, and topic for today's discussion is deeply religious societies are less developed societies, and I strongly disagree with this point. First of all, we will have to understand the meaning of religion and why they were formed. Point one being they were a point of socialization, and point two being that they were a measure of rules in which a certain society can function. Then when we talk about development, I guess the house can talk about what metric of developments we will be talking about, be it education, be it earnings, or be it crime per person in that particular religion. We can also talk about the impact of globalization and how the religion has changed throughout the world, but also compare and contrast it with the historical India, in which the Indian subcontinent had very strong religious beliefs, but was also at the pinnacle of development.
Okay, I think Samir, you can go.
So, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Samir Chaudhary, and the topic for today's discussion is deeply religious societies are less developed societies. So, I think we can see there are some root words in this topic that are of very high importance for this discussion, namely deeply religious and less developed. So, we need to make boundaries in this discussion as what we mean by religion. I think religion is something that that has many definitions, and we need to explore all these kinds of definition in this discussion, because it's very necessary to, because religion is not something that is only related to ideology. It's also related to its cultural effects on the society as well, and also the nature of the religion. The second thing that I want to say is, what's the role of religion in the society? That's also we need to consider, because of the fact that these roles will intend decide the fate of whether the society can be considered a developed society or not. So these factors should also be included in this discussion. Another thing that I would like to say is the importance of religion. I think we all can generalize that religion is mainly created for social and spiritual development of a human. But as we see, a developed society is not only about spiritual or a social development of a society. It has many metrics like economic development or the environment that we live around, the quality of life that we have. So there are many metrics of development that we need to consider while we make our minds into what is considered less development. And then we go on for study of how religious societies can affect it, and whether or not if it is deeply affected or not. So I think overall, we can have very diverse views on it, and I would like to invite everyone to join this discussion and give a variety of dimensions to it. So thank you.
Apurv.
Hello everyone. So today's topic of discussion is deep religious societies are less developed societies. I think again there are two words over here: religious societies and development. I think there is no link or very little link between religious societies and whether they are developed or less developed or not. I am a little in disagreement to this topic. We have seen that religious texts themselves talk about development, but not the development that we see today. It's about the holistic development, the spiritual development that they want us, that they want our mind and body to have. Today's development is more about economical and social benefit. So as I said, religious, you can't take it, religious activities, you can't compare it with today's development, which is more about economics only. And to add a few more points in my introduction, I would say that we should understand the difference between living decently and living with a lavish lifestyle. Today's development is more about lavish lifestyle, and we have seen our great religious scholars living in a decent lifestyle. We can't say they are less developed or something, but maybe they are they have knowledge which is far more than any developed society human being contains. But we should have some regard to that, regard to the fact that being religious does not mean you are less developed. I will share a few more points later in the discussion, and for now I will just close my point and open the discussion further. Thank you.
Rudra.
Hello everyone. Today's topic of discussion is deeply religious society or less developed society, and I largely agree to this point. Maybe we have a different opinion. Like religion started with a different point, means different motive. Like it is started for our all around development, to enlighten us, to remain calm, to drive us in a good direction. And it is also included the development of the society. But if we see practically nowadays, we can see that those countries which are lessly strict about religion, they are more developed. You can take the example of USA. The religion is there, but they are not evaluating everything according to the religion. And because of this religion, many political groups and many other things, many industrial, many large leaders are making fool of us. They are trying to mislead us, and they are winning the elections in the name of the religion without giving importance to the development. Development means overall development, like health, technology. And practically, actually, the religion started with the same cause, but it is modified. And it is now changed and deteriorated, and its values are now gone. And now we are more towards we are now using religion to misguide others, to do other things. And I like to open this discussion and invite others to speak. And I have some other points which I will discuss during the discussion. Thank you.
Kostov? Good. Kostov?
Hello everyone, myself Kaustu. So the topic given to us is that deeply religious society are less developed societies. So the two important words in this line is are deeply and religious. So if they have used the religious, then I would have disagreed with this. But as they have used the deeply religious, I agree with this, because if before going into further discussion, we have to discuss what is a religion. Religion is nothing but that it gives a human being certain values or rules so that that person can live a great life. So religion is that only. So it is very personal thing. And human is very it is animal who like to live in the group. So when someone accept a religion, he believes in those thoughts. So the people with similar thoughts come together and they form the religion. Up till that, it is okay. But when people become deeply religious, then it affects, then it creates conflict. Especially in the country like India, where there are
different religions, and if every religion is deeply passionate about their religion, then their history says that there has been conflict. So what happened is that the whole resources and whole focus of the country goes in that direction to solve those conflicts. So that's where it becomes a barrier in the development of nation. That's why I agree with this point. A few of them may disagree with me, so I would like to listen to your points. So I would like to open this discussion for everyone.
Okay, Ashish. Ashish, we can't hear you. We can't hear you. You try till Abhinav.
Good evening, friend. I am glad to. Is the voice is clear, sir?
Yes. Go on.
Good evening, friend. I am glad to say that. I am glad to say open the opportunity for such an important topic which is given to us. In my opinion, that religion.
Here are some results.
Go on.
In my opinion, religion and society both are related to each other. And in my opinion, that though no any religions will told us to fight each other. There is a problem in my headphone.
You are facing some problems?
Yeah.
Okay, Ashish?
Yes, sir. Am I audible, sir? Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. And today's topic is deeply religious societies are less developed society. So, as far as my opinion is concerned, I am largely disagree with this subject. So coming to the religion is some set of rule which has cultural effect, and in the context of our belief and development is a vague word which has several aspect also. So religion and development are not always related. So opening to the discussion, I would like to invite all of you to join the heavy discussion on this topic.
Okay, Abhinav, you are okay now?
Yes, sir.
Speak for 1 minute.
Good evening, friend. I want to say that both religion and religion will tell us to live in harmony, not to fight each other. Since from the civilization, the religion has been developed only for the for the people to how to maintain harmony between each other and each other things of the society. And even if the creator is also there, then how we will create a harmony between them? So I am not totally agree that the given topic is suitable, because deeply religious means how you can interpret this thing, because religion is also a great master, but same time it also a bad teacher also. So how you can take this opportunity to religion to how to develop yourself or to just to create this harmony between the society, it is on our hand. So we have to we have to develop some technique, something.
Okay, now I think Abhinav, we need to close. So I open the house for the discussion now. You can start now.
Okay, so I want to cite a few examples because many of the participants have made a point that there is no deeply religious societies that are very much developed, and there are few key examples throughout our history. First one being the very prominent one, that is Vatican City. As we all know, Vatican City has very great socio-economic development factors. At the same time, we can say...
The time when we had great leaders like Aryabhatta.
Apoor, unplug yourself. Apoor, unmute yourself.
I want to also say that
so there are examples in the history
by British,
and then we also want on the top
British, they were the most
of very deeply religious society,
and they were highly devoted Christians, and they wanted to spread. At that time, they were the highest, most developed.
The similar thing happened in the World War II in the Germany with Jews,
which were religious war crimes, and they persist even today. Those war crimes were religious war crimes. I want to make that point very clear. And
exactly.
You know, today
exactly.
We see that ISKCON temples, they are the largest
development
chain of temples all
aspects.
Around the world. They are done by Hindus.
Aspects.
And we have Islamic countries who are mostly dominated by Muslims. They are the most
I agree with some.
In the Gulf countries, they are having the...
talking about the Islamic countries, which have their set of ideology, and they are very hard in their...
And I want to say that the religion and development but it is our duty how do we take in over there.
As far as people of some religion,
tell you to do other things in the society.
As far as one religion is not trying to impose something on another religion, it's okay.
Metrics on which development is studied. I think we need to study different metrics on
right.
Which
definitely,
is
the percentage
because
of
we cannot generalize development because there are many.
Yes, we cannot generalize. But as far as the history is concerned, it's been like that.
For the cultural development. And other
also,
economic development,
also,
we
also
have
I
to adapt
to add
others' ideology. How
definitely
we can proceed
also,
to the deeply linked societies don't accept generally the laws of others or set of rules of others. That's why we can say deeply religious societies are not that much developed.
Right, I believe everyone will agree that extremism is
what I'm saying. If you take the case of
extremity, yes, I agree with Pranjal.
The explosion that happened with this year before
I want to highlight
before
the
last week
the advantage
and
of
if you see the political situation in Benin, if you see the political situation in Benin, I am not saying political and religion, they are same thing,
religion should only
what I am saying is,
when people of some religion they go to the extremity, then it creates problem.
They are using to take the vote bank. If we take the example of Beirut, that explosion happened.
We are going on
last week. If you take the example, we keep
religion.
Yes.
If you take the example of the Jammu and Kashmir, there also their development is also not much because of this religious conflicts.
Religion is important, and the cause behind the foundation of the religion is to give knowledge, to give
the way of life to people, but sometimes they go to the extremities. That's
deeply rooted to religion. If we show ourselves as a religion, then
we
cannot grow. Right.
You need to allow others also to speak.
But the history suggests that it has been like that.
Religion also helps us to focus our efforts.
Yeah, but extremity of something is never good.
Yes,
when it comes to religion, that creates problem.
So it helps us in focusing those efforts.
Yeah, it helps us, but...
divided efforts won't help us in development. That's why I'm saying you cannot completely.
Yeah, united.
You cannot completely.
Extremity. But when.
That's what I'm saying.
But when the people of some religion they go to the extremity, then.
Socially,
then they.
Culturally, yes, I agree with you.
There is a difference.
The religion,
religion
helped us to grow. And if you look at the history, you can take an example. But we can also example the
history suggests that
Galileo, because of some extreme religious people, is not allowed.
Like we can take example of the Germany. Lakhs of Jews were killed because of the religious beliefs.
Rudra,
right? So I guess everyone
is can happen even coming countries other than religion also. I cannot agree on that.
All the religions.
All religions are not extreme religions.
Actually, I am not denying anyone's point.
Yeah, but there is a possibility that any religion can attain a extremity. So you cannot generalize.
All of you that.
Yes, you cannot generalize it.
But I am saying is if nowadays the context.
Some people are go in extreme and they are deeply religious, so they don't
extremity is never good.
Not all deeply religious people are extremists. Not all deeply religious people are extremists. Because there are many
saints. Some of them are. We should agree.
But not all. Not all.
But
not all.
If you take the example.
You cannot say that people from certain religion are like that.
There are many saints who are extremists, but they are not extremists.
All types of
extremist people are in every religion. So you cannot say that one religion has extremist people.
Like happiness index, like GDP growth, like technological growth.
Then are modern developmental metrics.
Then we can see many countries. That's what I'm saying. But in the present, context,
those factors are not there.
Very religious, and they have the highest number of literacy.
Yes, I am agreeing with all of you. But I'm saying, today's context, and in history also, you can take an example of Galileo. What happened to Galileo? Because his views are not allowed. Before them, they were saying that Earth is flat, and people are following it.
Example of Aryabhatta, Yunan, and Charak, they were ardent followers of Hinduism and they have
There are few people who are taking it to the extreme level. So that's where it's creating terrorism and all those problems.
What I'm saying is. Religion has lost its path now. People are misguiding it.
The people have lost the path. Religion was always in the right direction.
If you take an example of Muslim countries like Pakistan, Afghanistan.
We conclude now. So I start from Kostub. Can you please conclude the discussion now?
Hello. So we had very interesting topic. So we had a very fruitful discussion on this. So after the discussion, we concluded that religion is important as a human being because it gives values and a system for a human being to give a greater perspective of life and greater way of living life. And some things are collective efforts are required. So religion is good in that sense. But if people of some religion are going into extremity, so extremity of anything is not good, so then that in that case, it creates problem. And you cannot generalize the thing that people from certain religion are extremist. Extremist people are in every religion. So yes, religion is important for development, but deeply religious, it can be harmful for the society and it can be a barrier in the road of the development. That's all.
Okay. Rudra,
from the overall discussion that we had, the conclusion was many of us found that religion is started with a great cause and it lead us to develop socially, culturally, economically and technologically. The main aim was that, but nowadays what people are doing, they are misleading us, they are using religion in different cases. Still now also some very good examples are there. Those people are religious and they are doing it, but those who are deeply religious, those who are rooted with religious, they are not flexible with it, they are not allowing others' views, then it is difficult and it is causing many problems in today's society. You can take an examples. You can take many examples of many countries like Benin, like Muslim countries like Afghanistan, Pakistan, and we can take also examples like developed countries like USA, where overall development is quite high. That's my point. Thank you.
Okay, Ashish.
Yes, good evening everyone, and my conclusion is I'm not
disturbance aa raha hai bolo बोलो
सर But I would like to conclude that, although after that heavy discussion, I would like to conclude that religion is not always related to development. Although if it goes to extreme position, then it creates problem and it is in the path of development. So I would like to conclude that religion is always necessary but not sufficient for development. Thank you.
Okay, Apoorv.
So I am very glad to get this opportunity to conclude the discussion. And as I can see, we did not have a very smooth discussion, but the thing is, we made some very valid points over here. I think everyone was, everyone accepted the fact that really deeply religious societies are you can't compare them whether they are developed or not developed based on the religion or based on their religious faith beliefs. Also, people were making points about the extremism, and I agree with that misleading someone on the basis of religion, you can't consider those people as deeply religious. There have been several examples in the past about very highly religious scholars who have tried to spread their religion and spread humanity and peace, which are the basic pillar. One point that even earlier, even recent few hundred years back, when wars used to happen, people used to make war cries which were deeply religious, but I think they were not in the they were also not in the way that they were trying to hurt someone or something. They were just having the faith that pronounce these war cries, they have larger chances of motivating people and winning the war. So that was also a part of the mind development. So I think that yes deeply religious societies are developed and not less developed. Thank you.
Okay, Surendra.
Our GD topic was quite controversial. Few people gave like. Sorry, one second.
Okay, I come back to you, Samir.
Okay, so we had a very fruitful discussion, and I think religion and development is something that we all hear in news because it's a very political issue. What I would like to say is the discussion covered many aspects of both religion and development, and also the connection between them. I want to cite a few key points that the discussion had. So one key point that Rudra made about extremism, and I think I also agree with that point, that extremism is something which is always bad. What I want to cite is that the topic was about deeply religious and not specifically about extremism. And as cited by Pranjal and me also, there are many examples globally also. They have tested the times that there are many deeply religious people, but those were not extremist, and yet they were the most developed people of their times. So generalizing that extremism is there and extremism is the dominant factor that is lagging the deeply religious societies to become developed is, I think, not that much suitable. And also, there was one more fact that I think everyone can agree with the point that there is a certain characteristic about religion that makes development possible. That is, religion allows us to focus our efforts, and that has been put up by many participants of the group. And I completely agree that it is that one specific thing that has a major contribution towards development. And I think that is why in past also we have seen, even the Britishers, who were many times extremists also, but at their time they were highly focused towards something, to achieve something, and that's why they had economic development. And I again want to emphasize that this discussion also touched many aspects of development as cited by, for example, different metrics of developments like Global Happiness Index or the economic development or the social independence, as cited by many examples of Middle Eastern countries by Rudra also. So overall, I think it's a very vast topic, and generalizing any kind of a statement will definitely have a few exceptions which would have happened in some other country or some other time. And I think we had covered major aspect, major number of aspects that will affect this. And I think, yeah, we had a very constructive discussion for that. Thank you.
Okay, Bhupender.
Yes. Hello, friends. We had very good discussion on this topic. So we cannot say that deeply religious societies are less developed. But up to some extent, as discussion goes on and we discussed, that some societies are lacking in development because deeply religious people don't accept others' ideology very easily. So they are not that much culturally developed, and you can say in educational way also. So I think societies are developed, but deeply religious is different thing. And we discussed about extremism. That is, I think, different from deeply religious. So we had good discussion, and we explored both sides.
Okay, Pranjal.
We had a very good discussion on the topic given at hand. The discussion started with discussing about how the Indian society has contributed, where my friend Rahul mentioned about the Galileo, where I mentioned about this different yoga rishis from India. Then we moved towards the globalization part of it, that how the invaders, be it the Britishers or the Mughals, they were trying to have their religion being set up in India. But then we could see that that was not something which was very fruitful for India. For development, we talked about countries like Beirut, Lebanon, and the Middle East, where we see that there is a lot of extremism. But then again, we all of us agreed on the point that there is a very thin line which separates deeply religious and extremism. And I believe everyone would agree to that point. Coming to it, we were also trying to touch upon politics being a part of religion and how politics and religion can't be decoupled from each other. Politics definitely does have a role in getting the vote banks, as some of my friends mentioned, but that should be separate from religion, as religion should only teach us a way of leading our life forward and then focusing towards the goal of life. Thank you.
Okay, Surendra, would you like to attempt?
Yes, sir. Our discussion was quite controversial. A few people said religion doesn't do anything with development, and a few people said extremity is harmful to the society. I believe that religion stopped doing religion has stopped many people doing something. Like if you see women, they are not able to do many things because of the religion restrictions. So I think that religion has nowadays religion has doing more harm than good. So that's
it. Okay. So you know, I believe all of you can think of some examples always in any topic which is given. Let me ask you, can you give me some example of some countries? Because societies we are talking about, societies here can be some nation only. Can you give me example of some nation which is developed also and deeply religious also?
Middle Eastern countries.
Sorry?
Middle Eastern countries.
Middle East, Dubai.
What about Israel? What about Japan?
Vatican City. Israel developed, sir.
Israel, Japan, Vatican City.
Vatican City.
Vatican City. So these are developed and religious also. Now, can you give me name of some cities which are not religious but developed? America?
America.
America, people don't even believe in God. 60% people don't believe in God. Developed also, but not religiously, deep religious.
Russia.
No. Russia, you can say, yes. So, can you give me now some name of country which is deeply religious and not developed?
Pakistan.
Pakistan.
Pakistan, yes. Some Islamic, other Islamic countries also.
Pakistan.
Saudi Arabia also. Now, I will come to the point, how do you define development? I will come to that point also. But what I'm trying to say here is, during your discussion, examples make your discussion very comfortable. So, friends, to start my discussion, I would like to quote that there are examples of deeply religious societies which are developed also, deep religious which are not developed also. So not deeply religious but developed, not deeply religious but not developed. So we have all permutation combination present. Yes. Now second thing point here is cause effect. confusion, cause effect confusion. I mean, what leads to what? Is it that religion leads to the lack of development, or lack of development forces people to be religious and become fatalistic, have more faith on God? You know, when nothing goes okay, you go to temple, you say Bhagwan kuch karo, I'm not getting. But if everything is okay, you are not going there. So is it that you are not developed, so you become more and more fatalistic or religious? I mean, what is cause, what is effect? That also is to be seen. Second point here is development. So what do you mean by developed societies? You know, some societies take pride in their spiritual development. They say materialistic development we don't want. Go to Saudi Arabia, they will say we do not want materialistic development. That will spoil our culture. We don't want that. We want spiritual development, and we are spiritually developed. You think of what Buddha preached you, what Buddha said. Desires is the sole cause of sorrows. Desires. So if your religion does not motivate you to become ambitious, desiring, then obviously you will not run after materialistic things. You will be running after peace of mind, spirituality. So how do you develop the, how do you define the development? Maybe some societies want spiritual development, and hence they are not after spiritual, they are not after materialistic development. They are spiritually developed. So we have got all kind of examples here. Ab aise topics mein aapne bolna hai ki, friends, this topic is really interesting because we have got all kind of examples here. We have the societies which are deeply religious and developed, not developed, wo bol diya. Fir, friends, we also need to see what do we mean by development, spiritual development or materialistic development. If we are only confusing development with materialistic development, then it will have different interpretation. But if we are talking about here about spiritual development, then the interpretation is entirely different. So aap apne logic ko is direction mein le ja sakte the. अब है क्या कि अगर तुम पूरे वर्ल्ड में देखोगे तो पूरे वर्ल्ड में अफ्रीकन कॉन्टिनेंट विच इज कॉल्ड डार्क कॉन्टिनेंट, अफ्रीकन कॉन्टिनेंट, एशिया, वहां पे पीपल आर रिलीजियस, दे आर मोर रिलीजियस, रिलीजन ओरिएंटेड. एंड यू नो व्हेन यू आर हैविंग गुड लाइफस्टाइल, क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ इज गुड, यू आर मटेरियलिस्टिकली डेवलप्ड, यू आर नॉट वेरी मच इंक्लाइंड फॉर रिलीजन. दैट इज ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व्ड इन सम ऑफ द सोसाइटीज. सो सिंस यू हैव ऑल काइंड ऑफ एग्जांपल्स, आप अपने लॉजिक को ऐसे ले जा सकते थे. बाकी आप जहां पे एक्सट्रीमिज्म में चले गए, एक्सट्रीमिज्म में जाने की रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं थी, टॉपिक अलग था. यू आर डेविएटिंग लिटिल बिट फ्रॉम दैट. एक्सट्रीमिज्म इज डिफरेंट थिंग, यू आर नॉट सपोज टू डेविएट दैट मच. एंड आई थिंक देन पॉलिटिसाइजेशन ऑफ द रिलीजन, पीपल आर पॉलिटिसाइजिंग द रिलीजन. एग्जाम्पल्स विल मेक योर डिस्कशन वेरी कंफर्टेबल. यू कैन कोट, आई विल कोट टू नेम ऑफ टू एम्परर्स, अकबर एंड दिस औरंगजेब. You know, Akbar ke time pe the best era, ruling era India has seen, but he was not religious, deeply religious. He kept religion away from his administration. Whereas Aurangzeb, he was deeply involving the religion with the politics. So when you start mixing the two things, politics, religion and all, then somewhere development gets hampered. Development gets hampered. So these are examples also you can quote. That yes, it has some aspect of that also. इस तरीके से आप अपने points को ले जा सकते थे. लेकिन मैं वही बोल रहा हूँ कि if you start thinking of some innovative thing, that you see in the societies where, like Israel, like Japan, where their people are deeply religious, but societies are developed. That means their interference between administration, governance, politics with the religion is not there. Religion is the personal matter of people. It will not become the matter of government. But when religion becomes matter of government, then the development gets hampered. Something like that you can say. So whatever states ka example I gave you, Israel, Japan and all, where people are religious, they believe in God, but that is a personal matter. It is not the matter of the government. Government is not chasing some religion. That is not happening. So that way, interpretation of the religion is another thing. Interpretation of the religion. Then you can always say that religion has two aspects, spirituality, rituality. Spirituality is a good aspect, rituality is the bad aspect. So all these things can be done. So isme jo deeply word tha aur less tha, इन वर्ड्स पे फोकस मत करो, इसका फिलोसॉफिकल मीनिंग कुछ और था। आपके पास हर टाइप का एग्जांपल है, हर टाइप का एग्जांपल है, और आप ये बोल नहीं सकते हो कि ये स्टेटमेंट सही है, और आप बोलोगे कि हर टाइप का एग्जांपल आपके पास है। सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द टॉपिक गिवन टू मी, एंड फ्रेंड्स आई लार्जली डू नॉट एग्री विद द स्टेटमेंट, एंड आई वुड लाइक टू कोट सम एग्जांपल्स टू पुट फोर्थ माय पॉइंट। सो फ्रेंड्स, इफ वी टॉक अबाउट डीप रिलीजियस सोसाइटी, यस जापान इज, यस इजराइल इज, यस वेटिकन सिटी इज, but are they less developed? Friends, they are not. So can't you ask this question? I told you in your discussion, ask the question. So to put your point, just ask the question from the audience. So friends, can you not name the deeply religious societies which are developed also? Then I think this statement you will not agree. But yes, there are state societies which are deeply religious also, and they are not developed also. I mean, people focus a lot on the religion, but they focus on ritual part, not spiritual part. What is the ritual part? Misinterpretation of the religion. Practice, how you do it. So that ritualistic part, politicization of the religion, then that society is not a developed society. Like if you see Nepal is so much Hindu state. They talk about so much Hinduism, deeply religious, but not that developed. Similarly, there are so many Islamic states which are deeply religious, not developed. So this is what we need to understand actually about the point. Ab isme, भूपेंद्र आपने पार्शियली एग्री पॉइंट से स्टार्ट किया था, आई थिंक दैट इज हाउ यू इंट्रोड्यूस दैट आई पार्शियली एग्री, बट डिड यू गिव द रीजन व्हाई यू पार्शियली एग्री? वो आपने नहीं दिया
इन डिस्कशन, आई टोल्ड बट नॉट एग्जांपल,
नॉट इन द बिगनिंग। आई टोल्ड यू यू इन द बिगनिंग डाइसेक्ट द टॉपिक, डाइसेक्ट द टॉपिक एंड गिव सम पर्सपेक्टिव्स। वो पर्सपेक्टिव शुरू में दोगे दैट विल बी वेरी गुड। सुरेंद्र, यू कुड नॉट स्टार्ट एंड यू कुड नॉट वेरी वेल स्टेट द थिंग्स। You need to remove, Surrender, this hesitation of speaking. At least these 3-4 lines you should know, you know, till your GD. And you never know in PSU's GD, they may make the cutoff also, they can put it. You
understand? Yes, sir. NTPC have a separate cutoff.
NTPC have separate.
Cutoff, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So it is serious matter, you know. You need to do that. Yes, sir. You need to speak
how
out.
How much is it?
It is out of 5, 2 marks for OVC and other candidates, and I think 3 marks for general candidates, something like that.
Surrender, you are having a good rank, right?
Yes, sir.
What is your rank?
Third, 3.
3 rank, in what?
ECE, oh, sir, ECE.
Electronics, mein he, yes, you have got 3rd rank. Yes, so, sir. You know, you should be there inside NTPC. So, you speak out, man. You need to speak, right?
Yes, sir.
So I will arrange this session again for you tomorrow. We will do that. But okay, you speak out. If you will not speak out, believe me, he will not be in position to give you marks.
Okay.
You know, there was one of my school teacher. He used to say that if I want to pass you, you need to write something. If you don't write anything, I cannot pass you. If you write anything, I can pass you. So you need to speak something. If you do not speak anything, Surrender, he cannot give you marks at all. And you need to do that. IUCL has also come out, so I believe you'll get calls for that also. And
no, sir. For ECE, IUCL is there. Achha, no vacancies.
Sorry, you are from ECE. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So you have got the opportunity, man. You have got the opportunity. Speak, Surrender. Speaking is very easy. And believe me, NTPC is giving you chance to speak for 2 minutes. You use these 2 minutes to speak those lines which we have told. गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई नेम इज सुरेंद्र एंड आई टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी। उसको रोट मेमोराइज कर दो 4-5 लाइन्स को और शुरू में बोल दो, एंड देन कंक्लूड ऑल्सो, राइट? एंड इट विल सेव यू, आपको कट ऑफ नहीं होगा। एंड यू कीप योर माउथ शट, यू डोंट स्पीक एनीथिंग, बिलीव मी, दे आर गोइंग टू कट यू, दे आर गोइंग टू कट यू, बिकॉज दैट इज वॉट दे आर गोइंग टू चेक वेदर यू कैन स्पीक और नॉट। दैट इज समथिंग विच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। सो इफ इन दिस एंटायर डिस्कशन इफ आई एम टू कट समबडी, आई विल कट यू एक्चुअली, बिकॉज यू हैव नॉट स्पोकन, राइट? यू हैव टू स्पीक समथिंग। Got my point, Surrender? But yes, it is not difficult. It is not difficult. You can do that. The first time you have done, and revise those statements and lines, and then we can do that particular thing. Apoor, you have done extraordinarily good this time, man. It looks like your engine has started, Apoor. But what you were talking about, lavish and decent lifestyle, what was that? It was not related.
You should understand the difference between living decently and living with a lavish lifestyle. Because today's development is concerned more about lavish lifestyle. And we have deeply religious scholars who used to live decently. But they were more developed spiritually.
That is the same point which I was talking. Development means what? Spiritual or materialistic? You understand that? You were talking about the same thing. So this is good.
I think that Apurvi is saying that they are living decently. So I don't think so. There are many examples like ISKCON people and some other people. They are also deeply linked, but not living decently.
But that is just one example, yeah. I mean, there are hundreds of examples to counter that.
But contradiction is there, I think.
I think one exception can rule out your generalized argument. Like, it will be towards that generalized thing that we are, like, even one point also.
Okay, Kaustubh, you concluded that everybody agrees religion is important thing. Can you conclude that? Kaustubh? You concluded yes. That we all agreed that religion is important. Was that conclusion
for the development?
Yeah. If I give you GD, is religion at all required? If I give you this GD, is religion at all required?
It is very personal thing. You cannot generalize that it is required. It will vary upon person to person.
Because, yes. So like you said that you were giving this conclusion that religion is important.
Yeah.
Was that correct?
Yes, I think after listening to your points that various example of USA, I think
no,
I was
no, but you gave conclusion before you listened to me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I didn't think of those points.
No. My point is you are giving this conclusion on the basis of the discussion. Was it discussed?
Yeah.
I mean, can we say that it was discussed that religion is important? Was that conclusion of the discussion? I don't think so. Nobody said that it is important thing.
Yeah, few people said that it is important to give collective efforts for the development. So religion helps in uniting people. So someone said that.
Uniting people and development are different things.
Yeah.
They are different things.
No. But for development, for development, unity is required.
Okay.
So in that context, I said that.
Mm-hmm. Ashish, aapka...
like focused efforts are required. Like, wo bolna cha raha hoga shayad.
Okay. Sameer, aapka theek tha. Matlab discussion tumhara theek tha. Aapne kya line pakda hua tha, Sameer, aapne? What was the line? What was your entire line of discussion? Entire line of discussion.
Sir, mera... सर मेरा मतलब मेन आइडिया था वो ये था कि इस चीज को जनरलाइज नहीं किया जा सकता क्योंकि बहुत सारे एग्जांपल थे और सबसे पहले मैंने वैटिकन सिटी मेरे माइंड में आया था तो मैंने वैटिकन सिटी साइट किया था और उसी का ही फिर एक काउंटर आर्ग्यूमेंट आया था जिसको वापस से काउंटर प्रांजल ने कर दिया था एंशंट इंडिया का एग्जाम्पल दे के एंड देन मुझे भी एक एग्जाम्पल आया कि ब्रिटिशर्स जो थे ऑल्दो ब्रिटिशर्स ने हमें बहुत कुछ वेस्ट हुआ बट उनकी वजह से ही न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी जिनको हम मेनली मटेरियलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट बोलते हैं जो कि
प्रांजल आप ब्रिटिश के एग्जांपल प्रांजल आप दे रहे थे ब्रिटिश के एग्जांपल दैट दे वर डीपली
जी सर वो मैंने दिया था प्रांजल ने वो ओल्ड लाइक लाइक ओल्ड इंडियन मैथमेटिशियन या एग्जैक्टली
आर्यभट्ट
Yeah.
What you were saying, but you took it to individual people, no? Religious people, not societies. Aap society se nikal gaye.
Sir, mera point tha ki development, when we are talking about development, so if we see ancient India, so Aryabhatta, Yunan, Charak type ke logo ne apne society ko bahut contribute kiya, even though they were deeply religious. So that was my point.
But that is basically, that goes a little out of the topic. Individual fellow may be deeply religious and contributing to the society, but society whole may society. Not be developed as society.
Whole society.
Like, so society as a whole, mein ancient India mera example tha ki hum bahut developed the aur abhi shayad.
So jaise usne shuruaat mein sone ki chidiya bola tha, सोने की चिड़िया बोला था तब मेरे को समझ में आ गया था उसका पॉइंट वो क्या बोलना चाह रहा है प्रांजल तो मुझे क्लियर हो गया था उस टाइम कि वो एज अ होल डेवलप्ड बोल रहा है एंशिएंट सोसाइटी को तो दैट्स व्हाई आई साइटेड प्रांजल आल्सो इन माय कंक्लूजन
आप एक काम जरूर करना है सब लोगों ने कि जो टॉपिक दिया जाता है ना उस टॉपिक के आसपास ही रहो बहुत दूर मत जाना उस टॉपिक से डोंट डेविएट मच फ्रॉम द टॉपिक एंड उसके आसपास रहने के लिए थोड़ी थोड़ी देर के बाद टॉपिक को देखना जरूरी है कीप रीडिंग द टॉपिक द टॉपिक है क्या Because when you start discussing, no, sometimes you tend to go away from the topic. So at that time, what you have to do is you have to come back to the topic. You read the statement. They can have a statement and just discuss as per that statement. This is something which is important. Because otherwise, what will happen after 5-10 minutes, you will deviate away. somebody will start discussing and hostile discussion hote hote wo yahan se wahan chali jayegi kahin aur. So you need to read that statement again and come back. And during discussion, do not forget to mention and tell some of the members that, friend, I think we are deviating from the topic. This is not the topic. Because believe me, somebody will positively deviate. And you just be observant and look for that opportunity. Like, just keep on seeing who is deviating. Be critic. You know, critic ka job is very easy, I tell you. It is very easy because he is only to criticize, not to give his point. He is only to criticize. And I've seen many people, many students doing really good in GD by criticizing others. They have no points to add, but they only criticize. And from where they criticize, they find some point that he is deviating. So like somebody said, okay, that fellow was a deeply religious fellow. And then fellow critic will say, listen, Bhupender, here we are not talking about the religious people. We are talking about the religious society. So you are deviating from the topic. तो वो बंदा क्रिटिसाइज करेगा, बस क्रिटिसाइज करके चुप करवाएगा और अपना पॉइंट रखेगा. तो क्रिटिक बनके, बीइंग क्रिटिक, आइडेंटिफाइंग व्हेन समबडी इज डेविएटिंग फ्रॉम द टॉपिक एंड टेल हिम यू आर डेविएटिंग फ्रॉम द टॉपिक. सो लेट्स कम बैक टू द टॉपिक. यू विल शो योर प्रेजेंस इन द डिस्कशन. सो बी क्रिटिक ऑल्सो. देर आर सो मेनी सच स्मॉल फंडास बाई विच यू कैन शो योर प्रेजेंस एंड यू कैन बेसिकली ओवरपावर अदर्स. Because when somebody is discussing like Pranjal mentioned about Aryabhatta and you want to snub him, you can say, Pranjal, see, why you are even mentioning about Aryabhatta? There are great people in every society, whether it is deeply religious or not. So we are here not discussing about individual people. We are talking about entire society. I mean, great people are there in Afghanistan also. In Nepal also, you will get great people. We talk about Bangladesh. There are Nobel laureates in Bangladesh also. So, but that does not represent entire society. Here we are not talking about the individual, we are talking about the society. So you can criticize it. That way you can enter into it. Stick to the topic, find who is deviating, tell him you are deviating, come back to the topic, and this way you can show your presence in the discussion. And keep yourself very precise, short sentences in the discussion, in between. Why? Because long sentences, he will not let you speak. Do not come in argument with anybody for long. Don't come in, because he will deviate your energy in one direction. Because when you are in argument, you try to become basically answerable to him. You start explaining him. Don't try to do that. Do not try to become one-to-one with somebody and he's criticizing you and now you are to put forth your point. Don't do that. Just go away from that and again come back to the discussion. So it should never look like, okay, it was Pranjal versus Samir or Pranjal versus Bhupender. So Pranjal was telling something to Bhupender and Bhupender is telling something to Pranjal. It should not be that way. It should be that Pranjal is listening to everybody and he's telling to everybody. That is the discussion. One to one, you have to avoid. Keep to the point. Find the people who are deviating. Bring them to the discussion. Just be very, very shrewd. Be very, very sharp. Be very, very calm. Be composed. Enjoy the discussion. That is all you have to do it. And believe me, discussion is a very, very simple thing. It is not a complicated thing. If you get the art of discussion, it can be very good. I mean, that fellow, I think he's just left us, Rudra. Rudra, you are there? I can't see you. Rudra ka method is good. He's very calm.
I mean, yes, sir.
He's speaking, Rudra, very, he's maintaining the rhythm. Rudra is maintaining the rhythm. He is maintaining particular pace. So at what pace we should speak, at what decibel we should speak, learn from Rudra. At what pace, at what decibel, sound level and pace, learn from Rudra. Because with that pace, he will make himself feel, he will make his presence feel in the discussion. Wo aasta aasta bol raha hai, lekin strongly bol raha hai. Tum dekhna uska pace kaisa hai. Wo pace se wo maintain kar lega. Usko points bhi aa jayenge. Samir ke pace pe, unless until you have lot of points, though Samir has lot of points also, and Pranjal also. Pranjal aur Samir mein kya hai ki unke pace bahut fast hai. Us pace pe agar tumhe knowledge nahi hai to tum bol nahi paoge. Inke paas knowledge hai to ye bol pa rahe hain. Lekin Rudra ka kya hai, jo pace Rudra ka hai usme kam knowledge bhi hai tab bhi tum bolte rahoge. You can maintain your pace and you can speak with that. To wo cheez bhi hame ek dusre se learn karni hai. Fine. And this Surendra, if you have interview, just see how Pranjal is dressed. I think that is the dress you are to maintain. This tie and this shirt, you maintain this way, Surendra. Go there with the tie and everything. So Apoorv, you were dressed well when your interview? Apoorv, were you dressed well in your GD?
Yes, sir.
well dressed. Wearing the same white t-shirt and a blue color tie.
So which you are wearing today in the GD, yeah? In the interview?
That was not the dress I was wearing on interview.
Okay.
Or GD.
Anyhow, your interview is already on air now. I think some 1,000 people have already seen your interview. I don't know, it was not. Anyhow, but we'll have better interview, don't worry.
Yeah, actually, sir, I thought to give it as early as possible so that, you know, I can make any amount of errors and I can learn as fast.
See, this always helps. This always helps. Yeah. Even if you think you know nothing, just jump. That always helps. It removes the hesitation. That's it. It removes the hesitation.
Actually, I learned a lot of things from Apoor's intro from today's video, because his pace, I think, was very calm, and you know, the interviewer was able to understand everything, which I think I lacked somewhere in pace.
No, ठीक है अपूर्व का actually अपूर्व का technical knowledge थोड़ा सा उसने improve नहीं किया हुआ था. I think he wanted to go for mock and interview. That's it.
यही idea था कि एक बार दे देते हैं जितनी गलतियाँ करते हैं कर देंगे. उसके बाद सीख लेंगे.
लेकिन उससे क्या होता है कि हम लोगों की एनर्जी वेस्ट हो जाती है. You understand? Mock is something when we three four mentor sit and we take it. Go for snap.
सर मेरे को एक चीज पूछती थी, जैसे मैंने बहुत सारे लोगों के इंट्रोडक्शन में देखा कि लोग जैसे इंटरव्यू खुद का हो रहा है लेकिन दे टेल मेनी थिंग्स, लाइक वो अपने नेटिव प्लेस का बताते हैं, अपने फादर का बताते हैं, मदर का बताते हैं, क्या करते हैं, बट बहुत सारे लोगों के इंटरव्यू मैंने देखा कि वो ये भी बोलते हैं कि माई मदर ऑल्सो राइट्स पोएम्स, वेरी गुड पोएम्स. तो सर क्या ये पॉइंट, ऐसे पॉइंट अपने मदर या फादर के बारे में डालना, इज इट करेक्ट और यू शुड अवॉइड इट, कि तुम्हारे ऊपर फोकस है तो तुम अपने बारे में ज्यादा बोलो.
See, I tell you one thing, yaar. I give you one example. I was having two friends, you know. One, both of them were after girls in the college. And both used to say, I love you to girls. One always used to get accepted, another never. You know, the difference was how he used to say, I love you. I think that was the difference. So if you say, sir, should we say, I love you to the people whom we love? Answer is yes, you should. It is not what you're saying. It is how you're saying. See, if you tell some girl, see, I really love you a lot. And I love you from the core of my heart. Nothing in this world I appreciate more than you. This is one way to speak. Secondly, see, I love you. And you should agree this. And you should listen to me. I really love you. You do not have any other option but to love me only. That's it. So this is another way to say. These all things, whatever you mention, they are acceptable. If you say, sir, I want to mention my father is doing job in this, and sir, my mother is housemaker, but sir, I want to tell something very peculiar about my mother. Though she is not literate, but she is an excellent writer. And I believe my hobby of writing, I have inculcated from her.
Okay. So that means we need to relate ourselves also.
Yes, somehow. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
To have, you know, to reflect our ability also from that point.
Okay, yes, yes. But if you say, for the sake of saying, it will be obvious. Sir, my father is running the business and my mother is housemaker and she's a good writer also. So then it is no meaning. It has got no meaning then. So you should not provide information for the sake of providing. You should give information when it has. So 10 people saying same sentence will have different meaning. Same sentence, but it will have different meaning. It depends how you are saying. Your gesture, your posture, your eye contacts, your passion, your believing. First, whatever you say, you should believe that. Whatever you say, first, you should believe that. Then only other will believe. Otherwise, nobody is going to believe.
Sir, one more thing I want to ask. In the introduction for interview, do we need to maintain a chronological order or the one that is most impactful or that you want to highlight yourself, that has to be mentioned?
You, again, Samir, it is flexible. Everything is flexible. There is no pattern, there is no structure. Everything is flexible. All I can tell you is when you give me introduction, I can tell you whether it is okay or not.
Okay.
Only thing. It's a long, it's not long, it is short, it is this way, that way. Once you give me, then only I can give you.
Okay, sir. I'll get another snap into tomorrow.
So that is how all this can be done. Fine?
Okay.
So I think we end it up now. Paranjal, how was your experience? I think Pranjal is the only fellow who is still in college as of now. Pranjal, introduce yourself to all of us here.
Hi, I'm Pranjal Shukla. I just completed my third year. I'm a student at BITS Pilani, Hyderabad campus. And I'm
doing my bachelor's in engineering and mechanical engineering. So I have been preparing for GATE, but I really found the Yourpedia portal helpful. And probably these group discussions and all the discussions which are in the group might help me with my placements as well. So I'll stay connected. Okay.
So he's still in college. So that is what is a capable boy, I think. Pranjal, you are doing really good and you keep proceeding on that direction. Whenever you get opportunity and time, so you keep yourself and you will learn from others also. Like Surendra has got a very good rank and Samir is very good in discussion. Apoorv is an experienced fellow. So all these guys are very good, you know. So you can learn from all of us and we learn from this kind of discussion. Fine. So we say goodbye now to each one of us. Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
Good night, sir. Good night.
Good night, sir.
Good night, sir.